Meat City, baby.
Hello and welcome back to Meat City Gaming. JD here with another Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes video, and today I am once again hunting my white whale. This is the Dark Side Territory Battles special mission on Phase 6. This is the bonus special mission. I have tried this thing numerous times at this point using different compositions, different teams, different strategies, and I have just come up a bit short time after time. So today we're going for the latest rework of the strategy, and what we're going to do is use mostly an Imperial Trooper team, and it's going to be augmented by Imperial Probe Droid, who is a required forced character. And in this mission, you're forced to use General Veers in the leader slot and Imperial Probe Droid as one of your five characters. So I have more powerful Empire characters, but they don't really synergize with the Veers lead. So I'm running a Trooper team. They are all Gear 11, and I put good mods on them. Some of them are modded fairly well, so I left them alone. One or two of them got sets of my arena mods, but some of those arena mods are the Tier 6, so they won't go on anybody who's not Gear 12, and these guys are not Gear 12. So what we're doing is an all-offensive type setup. Last time I tried this same setup, but I used Shore Trooper, I think in place of Starck, and that just did not work out. The whole point to Troopers is getting that first kill. So you get the first kill, you get a bunch of bonuses, you get a bunch of turn meter, you get the train rolling, and then you can just chain out the kills. So using Shore Trooper, he didn't have enough potency, enough firepower to help get through that, and sure, he soaked up damage, but eventually they started healing and they started getting turn meter, and then they just burned him down and it wasn't good enough. So we have the speed modded correctly, so Starck goes first, gives out some of the buffs. We could go with the grenade here, but I think it's a little bit early, so instead we'll go and hopefully we'll get at least a daze. We don't. Okay, this is the big moment. It's going to be the swarm attack. We're looking to take out the rebel pilot here. If we don't do it, Shore Trooper does have a follow-up, so hopefully that'll be enough, but we need to get a kill here to get this thing going. So let's see what happens. There's the swarm attack. It's not quite enough. Now, do we go with the single target attack, or do we go with the AoE sweep? I'm going to go with the AoE sweep, and hopefully we see that rebel pilot go down. There we go. Okay. Bunch of turn meter. Offense up. Things are looking good. Snowtrooper gets to go again, and again, we're going to go with the sweep, because we got a lot of enemies up. We can get a lot of crits. We do. Now we have things going here. We can stagger the enemies with the Blizzard 4 barrage, and we're going to save the scan here from Probe Droid. That's not what we're really looking for at the moment. We do want to knock down some turn meter. We've got staggers here. I can't really tell. I don't think that guy's staggered. So instead, let's go for the soldier. He was staggered, so that knocked him down. And now we're looking for our next kill. And the soldier, I believe, is going to taunt anyway, so let's go there. We can put out Deathmark from Terminate, so we can get this next kill pretty quickly. Let's do that. We just need to not get it cleansed here. One big hit, one more. Down he goes. Now we can throw out the grenade. I think that's a good choice here. Get all that stealth. Not quite enough. We'll use the sweep attack, and we're hoping to get that hidden stealth trooper in the back there. He had a lot of protection. That was enough to keep him up. Let's see if we can burn down the officer. We're really close here. And I'm checking my turn meter. If we use this scan all wavelengths, I don't know if we'll get another turn before the officer goes. I don't think we will, but I also don't think the debilitating shot is going to be strong enough on its own to take this guy out. So that's the question. If I knew this would take him out, I would definitely do it to get the boosts. But because I don't think it will, I'm leaning more towards getting out the additional buffs, getting out the additional bonuses for those buffs. So we're going to think about it for 1 second. And yeah, that's an elite unit. I don't think we have the firepower. Let's get the buffs going. And he does get a full heal in. Not what we were looking for, but let's switch now to the soldier. And a miss, which is not great. We're not going to mess around here. We do need a kill, so we get that stealth off. And we kill the weak target, which is good. And now let's keep going on the rebel soldier here. We'll see if we can get a daze or a stun. We don't. one more sweep. There's three of them still up, so we can still reduce the cooldowns there. And now we have things pretty well in hand. We want to go into the next wave with as many specials available. We're not going to use the AoE sweep there. We're not going to use the call to assist. We're just going to single target, basic these guys down, and we should roll into this with fairly high turn meter, as well as protection and health. Everybody is just about topped off, so that is really good. And we're through the first wave, so already better than last week when I had Shore Trooper in here. And great news, we get to start off with the big AoE attack. And we're going to go for the Scout. He can stealth, but we do have the AoE, so even if we don't kill him, we do have some options to still take him out. So let's do that. We're looking for some big hits here. We do get a stun, which is nice. We'll go for the AoE. Not a whole lot of damage there, but we can buff up. Don't like seeing a daze on Veers. Nothing we can really do about it right now. And there's no taunt up. There is a soldier and a soldier over here. So we don't want to waste the grenade because that can strip away taunt. So instead, we'll just go for two big hits. Yeah, Death Trooper hits really hard. And that's a good shot. We get our first kill. We get the offense up. And things are rolling. So now we can use the Overwhelming Assault. Punch out some more damage here. Let's get some staggers out. I'm a little worried about the commander going. If he does his cleanse, then I'm wasting all those staggers, but I don't know for sure, and I feel like it's the right move, so we're going to do it. And yeah, we did have our instincts were correct there. He did have a cleanse, and he did remove those staggers. Not ideal. We'll keep that in mind for next time, but good news. We do have Death Mark ready on Terminate here. Do we go for the soldier who's not elite, or do we go for the pilot? My inclination is to... So the soldier has defense up, so he's going to be more resistant here, but it doesn't really matter. And I don't want to get stuck behind the taunt. Let's do it. Oh, he got stealthed and healed. That was really unfortunate. Okay, we're going to have to try and work through the pilot. We need one more nice move here. Well, that'll help if we can get one of those down. We do. Great. And here's where you want the grenade. That can remove the taunt, remove the stealth. And I think we're in good shape here. Do we go with the buffs? I think we're still early enough in the wave. We'll get that back. Let's get some buffs going. The daze on our units is not what we're looking for right now, but hopefully that'll start to fall off. We've got the other soldier here. We're just going to try and pound through him. He can counterattack, but maybe we get a daze. We don't get a daze. We don't get a double attack. A little bit unlucky there. I need a big hit. I don't want to waste... probe droid going in here, and wow, we're getting weak. We need a big hit. We're going to save Terminate for a full health guy. Starck is looking low. We need to avoid him. Oh, that is unfortunate. Wow, what a perfect snipe that was. And if we shoot the spy, he goes into stealth. So that's pretty much going to wrap this up. There's no way we're coming back from losing Starck going into the final wave here. We will, of course, give it a shot, but... That's not going to happen. Basic to get down. Now we have just the spy left. Looking for a double tap here. We get the daze. We get the stun. That's all nice. And we do. We'll save probe droid's explosion for going into the final wave. Maybe it'll be enough if he can go super early in the wave. Let's see what happens here. But yeah, the Ahan gets to shoot first. And I'm guessing doing the AoE here is going to be bad because it'll lead to a lot of counterattacks, but let's test it just for the sake of testing. Okay, no counterattacks is good. I feel like we need Han to go down. Can we do it with this self-destruct? Let's go. It is enough to take out Han. That's a good removal. Go for another AoE sweep. We can do a terminate here. Do we do it on R2-D2? I feel like the pilot is not an ideal target here, but we really need to get another kill to keep things moving. We are going to get a follow-up from Veers, so let's do it. Let's get Terminate out there. We do need to get this kill, and we can do another AoE. And we could use the grenade. Let's do it. Then I think we can get the other stealthed spy here. And we can do the call to assist. That should be enough. Let's do it. Good, another kill. We'll do the AoE again. And we're trying to get R2-D2 down here. I don't want him to stealth up or start stunning people. Go for another sweep. And, oh, this should be good enough. Okay, this is really, really close. Now, maybe we can salvage this after all. Chewbacca is the Clone Wars version. He should not be putting out too much damage. No real big abilities on him like the legendary Chewbacca. Oh, a miss from Deathtrooper. Really unfortunate. We'll do the call to assist. And no need for the grenade. Let's just go for hopefully a stun. Oh, a stun is good, but a full heal. All right, let's start chopping down here again. We can get Terminate out. Good. Deathmark is on. One big hit. Two big hits. Nice. Okay. Three on one. This should be good. We get one here, one stun. We're in good shape. The officer is in trouble. Wow, I forgot about the the special ability gets called in, but this call to assist might be enough. Here we go. Boom! First time defeating the special mission. Wow, it looked really bad there in the second wave when we lost Starck early. A little bit of bad RNG, a little bit of, I think, bad luck, maybe some bad planning on my part. But we tried it out, stuck with it, got the early explosion on Raid Han, the big damage dealer there. Thankfully, we took him out with Probe Droid. I'm guessing if I lost the RNG and IPD got stunned by Han with his shoot first ability, that probably would have fell apart. So maybe it's not quite repeatable yet, but definitely the foundations are there. Definitely a chance to be successful. That is an all Gear 11 team. I will go through now and show the members of the team in a little bit more detail so you can see what they look like. I'll have that at the end of the video when I stop the commentary. You can see the mods on them. You can see the abilities. I think they're all Omega'd. Veers definitely has his Zeta leadership. I don't think there's any other Zetas on the team. But again, they will follow here. You can take a look and know what you need if you're trying to complete this on your own. This is no Gear 12s on this team, and we were able to beat the Tier 6 Phase 6 Special Mission in Dark Side Territory Battles. So hopefully you guys found this video useful. This was a fun one for me to make. I wanted to do the live commentary. I think it's a lot of fun when I'm trying something new, figuring it out, and hopefully having some success. So there were a lot of failed attempts where I was recording videos and the run was terrible and fell apart, and those didn't make it to the channel, but this one certainly will. So if you enjoyed it, leave a comment. Let me know in the comments below. Thank you for joining me, and I will see you next time.